Measurement Unit Section 1, Multi-Step Problems. In this first example, they're asking us to convert 3.5 days into minutes. Our conversion table doesn't have time, and most of us, if you think about it, don't know how many minutes are in a day automatically. So, to convert days to minutes, we're going to have to come up with a second conversion. And that second conversion is to temporarily convert our days into hours. And once it's in hours, we can convert it into minutes. The procedure is basically the same. We're still going to start with the given value as a fraction, which means we're going to put a denominator of 1. And then we'll set up our conversion factor fractions that are equivalent to 1 so that the days cancel out. And our plan was to convert first days into hours, and then plugging that information in there, we have 1 day equivalent to 24 hours, and here's our conversion factor fraction arrangement so that the days are going to cancel out. And before you pick up your calculator to simplify this fraction, lay out the remaining conversion step so that we can do this all in one calculation. So now what we have left, unit-wise, is hours. We're halfway there. Next, we need to cancel out hours and express it in an equivalent unit of time in minutes. So we're looking for the relationship between hours and minutes. We want to cancel out hours. So we will put the 1 hour in the denominator, so it cancels out our unit of hours in the numerator. The equivalence of 1 hour is 60 minutes. Here we have our second conversion factor fraction, which is canceling out the hours. Minutes is in the numerator. That's a good sign that we've got this set up correctly. And now we'll grab the calculator and simplify the fraction multiplication. We are going to multiply all the numerator values together, which means we're taking 3.5 times 24 times 60, resulting in 5,040, and the minutes is the only unit that's remaining. In the denominator, we have 1 times 1 times 1, which is 1, and dividing any number by 1 gives us that value. In this next problem, we're given 2.8 pounds and asked to convert it into grams. The plan is pounds to grams. When we look at our conversion table, these two values aren't in the same unit of measurement. We have 16 ounces is equal to 1 pound, pounds and tons, and we have to jump over here, ounces to grams. The common relationship that crosses between English to metric is that ounce. So to go from pounds to grams, we're temporarily going to have to convert pounds to ounces and then continue on with the conversion into grams. Now that we have our game plan set up, we're going to follow the same conversion steps with taking the given value, expressing it as a fraction, which means we put a value of 1 in the denominator. We want to multiply by 1, our conversion factor fraction, so that the pounds cancels out. And from the conversion table, we saw that 1 pound is equal to 16 ounces. The pound factor goes in the denominator with its equivalent 16 ounces in the numerator. Next, after we cancel out pounds, we're left with ounces, and the relationship between ounces and grams, our final conversion factor. We want the relationship of ounces in the denominator in those equivalent values so that our current ounce factor in the numerator is going to cancel out. That value is 1 ounce is equivalent to 28.3 grams. Arranging that conversion factor fraction gives us the following. We can see the ounce units canceling out, leaving us with grams in the numerator. That's our indication that we've set this up correctly. Once we have it laid out, now we'll grab the calculator to simplify this fraction multiplication. Multiplying the numerator values together, 2.8 times 16 times 28.3 results in the following value. In the denominator, we have three ones multiplied together, which gives us 1. Anything divided by 1 is that value. A value of 1,267.8 grams. You're now ready to try some practice on your own, found in the textbook on page 6.